Good day, gentlemen. This is Mr. Israel Blargh, and I'm obviously here today with my co-host...
SwashbucklingSir! Hi!
I decided we switch characters
all sorts of sirs.
Yes. You swashbuckle all kinds of sirs. That actually seems kind of naughty.
Yeah, okay. It is a very depraved sexual act that I engage on every weekend. It's quite
interesting.
Awesome.
Interesting. Okay, let's just forget of all these naughty parts and let's just continue exploring other naughty parts, which is Spelunky Mines.
Yes, the mines.
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, yeah!
Presume you're climbing down the rope.
Yes.
Good. So we finally managed to actually be in sync once. Cops. I'm amazed.
I'm also quite surprised we have fulfilled our life mission now. We can just kill ourselves.
Oh man, there are 3 gems right at the start. I really want to ghost these.
Nope. Just grab them and go.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, I never end up ghosting anything in 1-1 because anytime that I try, I end up killing myself with a ghost. It's really uncanny. It's really weird. I waited a few times and I think about 90% of the time I've killed myself.
You go for this crate.
Yeah, I did, and you will never regret it.
Okay. Probably I will superbly regret it. Yes! Climbing gloves.
Oh yeah. We are overpowered now.
I told you we should have ghosted. The webgun, man. You can go back up with a webgun.
Yeah, now we have the power to go back up. By the way, this is the daily challenge for July 29th,
totally
in case
true.
You are unable to read the little label down there. I think I'm just going to leave 1-1 because this is just foolish.
Oh man, I'm...
Are you still doing things in 1-1?
I'm also out of here.
Yeah. No, that was stupid.
Yeah. But it was 10,000, you know? That's not too shabby, actually.
It would have been like 35,000-40,000 if you had ghosted that.
Yeah, so it's not too bad.
Yeah. But no thanks.
Oh,
too
snake
much work.
Pit. Snake pit.
Oh, it's good stuff.
What is in there?
And I'm going to just jump in and find out that way.
Yeah, okay, I see.
I am without fear.
So you're probably hoping to hit the head of the snake down there?
Oh no, well I am jumping in but very cautiously.
Aww, you're so boring today.
I think the webgun already killed the snake anyway. Because I dropped that first in case there was, you know, arrow traps and whatnot.
Yep. Okay.
Blow this up, yes.
So you're still using the webgun.
It is the best item in the game, I cannot blame you for it.
Oh, you're not using it anymore?
Well, now I have something a little better best item in the game.
Well,
it's a paradox.
How is that possible?
So we're all going to die now because
you're cheating.
I created a weird paradox where I'm using something better than the best item in the game.
Yeah, I mean, that's clearly cheating.
Yeah, I just spawned in like a double jetpack. It lets you fly and creates explosions in your wake. It's really awesome. It's a new addition.
How do I do this?
Are you trying to murder the poor man? What would you do then?
No, I'm still grabbing. I think I'm a tad slower than you are.
Oh.
I'm still thinking about what to do with this mattock, actually.
Keep it. Have fun with it.
And yes, I did see the shopkeeper, and yes, I was thinking about killing this man.
Oh no, man. This is probably a really bad idea.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it?
I'm using the mattock to murder him, and it worked out. And I don't feel bad in the slightest about my murder.
Oh, the ghost is here already? Oh, Jesus Christ, ghost.
Already,
here.
I know. It's
fast. It's crazy, I can't do this. Okay, wait. Let's get this stuff ghosted first. Ah, no! Down, you faggot. I didn't even kill the shopkeeper yet. Chill! You're too quick!
I don't think I'm ghosting anything else. I'm just grabbing what's at the bottom and going away.
Oh, I wasted my parachute. Nice.
Bad! Bad swashbuckling, sir! That parachute was all that stood between you and death.
Well, too shabby. Well, then apparently I'm not ghosting anymore because I just grabbed the gems. Smart. I just really randomly grabbed the first gem and I was like, well, since I messed up the first one, it's not even worth waiting for the second one either.
That's right.
So I picked
That's
the second
really good
one
reasoning.
I mean, it's just like, I mean, this is also already fucked, so might as well, you know, mess it up. Nice. If I could not kill myself, that would be really awesome. Okay. So you're already gone, right?
All the gems. Nothing to see here.
Are you in 1-3?
Yeah.
I see. So you didn't like ghosting 1-2?
I ghosted what was at the bottom, and that was it.
Oh, I see.
Like 3 gems, that was... Yeah, that was the whole.
Thinking about it, how to go about this whole thing. Because I still have to kill this spider, and I don't really have much room to work with a ghost here. And I really do want the spike shoes.
I'm going nuts with the Madoc because I don't want to keep it past this level, so I'm just using it super liberally.
Yeah, I mean, I get it. You want to probably grab the shotgun.
Yeah,
just
I don't
want
to die horribly.
The safe option. Okay, well.
And these shopkeepers are incredibly difficult to deal with. There was a stupid higher help at the bottom. And it ruined everything.
Good to know.
Oh, what the? Oops.
So I don't really have much time to kill the shopkeeper here. Well, let's see if I survive.
That's really friggin' dumb.
Because I'm not really wanting... I don't really want to spend even more resources than this.
Yeah, all I really want is access to the exit. That's really all I'm aiming for here,
but... Ugh, that was close. It's always when you have, like, really tough jumps, I always start doing sounds, and in my mind, suddenly... these jumps become easier. I know, it doesn't make any sense.
The more sounds you make, the easier the jumps become.
Yeah, right?
It's like having a net under you is safety.
Yeah, it's called safety net.
Indeed, with your sounds, yes.
Okay.
Well, I think I'll resort to picking up this idol and hoping that the shopkeepers will just explode.
Well,
I think that's a pretty good strategy.
Yeah, sure. Makes sense.
Makes all the sense in the world to me.
Yeah, well, that's why you usually die very quickly. Oh, fuck.
I wish
say
I
it and jump into the ghost. Oh, that was so dumb.
Did you just die?
Yeah, I jumped into the ghost. Oh, that was so bad.
Your failure is complete.
Yeah, I kind of really wanted to get this going. I wanted to, you know, get to the next level, and... yeah, that's what you get for being AC.
This is what happens when you do this when you're butt-tired like you are.
Ah, well. I just wish I was just AC again. That's really just it. Because that was actually not a really hard jump, I should have maybe, you know, I wanted to do a very short circle with a ghost instead of a large safe one, because I was like, yeah come on, I don't really want to waste even more time, so...
What could possibly go wrong?
Yeah, well, that's the thing, it didn't feel, so when I, you know, when I had the idea in my mind, it didn't feel very off, because it was like, this is a jump I've done a million times, it's going to be fine.
Yeah, that's the thing. When you do stuff like that, it's so easy. I mess it up so often. Like, a really silly jump that is... Oh, this is totally going to happen. I just need not to make the mistake, and you always make the stupid mistake.
It's true. I mean, it could have just gone underneath the ghost. Well, you know, if you could redo it again, you would probably do it differently. But that's not how the world of Spelunky works. That's actually what I really enjoyed about our Frozlunky runs. You could redo the same seed multiple times.
Yeah, we should probably do that again. I wouldn't mind.
Yeah, that was fun.
Playing some Frozlunky instead of the daily challenge, which we, you know, we do every day. So it's not like it's a new challenge or anything. We're not.
Well, it is kind of
it is
new.
Technically a new challenge in shape, but not in form, you see.
But sometimes the challenge is not new, is it? Because I remember so when I did some dailies, it was like, I've done this before, I've seen this before, I know this seed. Did you have this too?
I think it happened once to me. Like, it's weird. It's the exact same seed I just did. What's going on?
Yeah.
This is the system goes bonkers sometimes, I suppose.
Yeah, I think it has to do with the date, because the seed is somehow generated with the date in it. And if the date is, I don't know, so if it's, let's say, 5th of June, and the next is then 6th of May? Does this make sense? What did I just say?
I don't know.
So if you have, like, the numbers vice versa, then this might occur. At least that's what I've heard theories on. I don't know if that's right, actually.
My boulder plan actually worked.
Nice.
I think. I didn't kill everybody, but it was enough.
Well, sometimes you just need a little space.
Sometimes you just need to kill enough people to survive, you see.
Well, I find most of the time it's actually the problem is not the shopkeepers themselves, but usually that they have like a very weird space that they occupy. Like, it's a very tiny area they are in, and it's not really easy to, you know, just shoot them. And if you have space, then you can shoot them.
It's everyday life, but sure, it does apply to Spelunky.
Yeah.
So what are you up to now? Are you doing speedruns or?
Well, I'm actually haven't quite decided. I'm just fumbling around
just going
in
forward.
Well, I don't know. Maybe crazy stuff. Let's see. What does this shopkeeper have? A camera. I need this. No.
You must have that camera.
Okay, that's actually perfect because now I decided I'm going to try the well-known, awesome, and still yet undefeated for me, no gold run. Let's do this.
Oh yeah, it's totally gonna happen.
If it happens today, I'm going to laugh.
You must keep the camera because you must do science to Spelunky.
Well, I just died.
Oh, okay. So, well, the no gold run is still
is on. Now in effect. It is totally no gold run. Totally, utterly going to not fail ever. Because, you know, it's a no gold run. How could this ever fail?
I don't see how. It's so freaking easy.
I really want to kill this shopkeeper in the no gold run. Yeah, I should totally do this. It seems like a smart idea, right?
I want to.
Okay.
Terribly wise path.
Yeah, well, I'm not a terribly wise person. As you could clearly see by me jumping into the fudging ghost. So, yeah, good enough. Well, I really did want the climbing gloves, though, because they make, should I get there, the ice caves a lot easier. I mean, I don't think I ever came to the ice caves, to be quite honest, in a no-gold run.
With a no-gold? I think you got to the temple once.
Did.
You were doing it.
I did get to the temple once. Oh my god, how does this shopkeeper escape? How did this guy escape? That doesn't make any sense. Go away.
This vault, I cannot get it. I only got 2 bombs left because I threw them all away like a dumbass.
Aww.
I just feel sorry for me, man. You should feel.
Really have to get it anyways.
Real steel.
That's the rule. Oh, right, I do have a shopkeeper at the exit now. I totally remember. Well, it doesn't make things easier, does it? Hmm. Man, well, he is dead.
Haunting me.
And I did run into the arrow trap. That was smart. Hmm. Where's the dog? It's up here, right? Let's grab this one. So, that's but foolish. Skipping... I mean, if you skip one vault, it shouldn't be the end of the world.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to. There's nothing I can do about it. I don't think I could even get to it with just two bombs.
Yeah,
so
well...
it's not even a choice of, oh, should I be with zero? Can't even make that choice, man. That's how rough I have it.
Well, life. It's all just about fake choices anyway. So I mean, you can't choose your own face. It's not fair.
Speak for yourself, I'm a shapeshifter. Don't laugh at me and my shapeshifter ways.
Yeah. Okay, I try.
How could you? This is disrespectful. I'm going to sue you for discrimination.
Against shapeshifters. I see.
Just gonna grab the damn money and go.
Yeah, just that's like exactly what I'm not robbery. Trying to do. Not grab the damn money and still go.
Oh, this is stupid. Whew. What am I doing?
Okay. So, jungle. So this is where the fun begins.
Oh, yeah? Jungle with no gold. That's pretty damn good. That's further than I get in, like, 85.2% is of all my
runs. 85.2. Well, you did the maths on that.
Yeah, I've done 1,000 runs by it, so I have that kind of sample data to do the 0.2. Actually, you would need more than that. Wouldn't you need like 10,000 to do the 0.2? I don't know. This is a really dumb line of thought.
So if you want to get 0.2, you just need 1,000. So, I do have a cape now, and I do have a bunch of bombs.
800.
So it's actually not too shabby to kill the shopkeepers if you somehow can avoid grabbing their money. Because you do get quite helpful items.
Yeah, but then it's a real pain in the ass to deal with them at every exit and stuff. I don't know. Makes it pretty damn tough.
Yeah.
I guess it's a trade-off. You have to weigh your pros and
cons. Whoa, shopkeeper, go away. What the fuck? Whoa.
Well, you sound like you're still alive.
Yes. Well, that's positive, right? Wow, that really shocked me. In case you didn't realize.
I had a slight suspicion that you were surprised by what just happened.
Yeah. Shopkeeper was escaping. I mean, I saw it coming that he was escaping, but I didn't really... Because I thought if he somehow manages, I'm going to be dead anyways. And he escaped and didn't kill me instantly. And I was like, oh, that's taunting me. The royal jelly is inside of gold. Oh, you are so cruel, Spelunky. No.
You should pick it up just out of spite. Just to show Spelunky who's boss.
Oh man, that is so not fair. Oh my goodness.
Market might be here, I don't have the resources to find out, so keep going.
You still have only two bombs.
Yeah, there's just... there was a bunch of crates, but they had a freaking parachute on... what's it called? A compass. Not helpful. Man, I could get 4 gems with just one bomb, but I can't spare the freaking bombs!
But it's a daily challenge! Think of all the monies! Did you spend the bombs?
And there's a web gun in a crate, obviously.
Well, that is very helpful.
Excellent. I'm happy to find that.
Okay. How do you go on about killing shopkeepers without haste? Oh man.
With your fists!
Yeah, that totally sounds like a very smart idea. I should listen to the guy who's still in the daily challenge and alive.
Yeah. I have great advice for you.
Thank you. I think I'm just going to avoid them. Well, that's what I'm going to try, anyways. Can I get down here without grabbing the skulls?
There's an odd vault here that I cannot get because I just don't have it. Damn bombs. That's why so hard.
No! Why am I so stupid? Why do I jump into things today? I really, literally jumped into this gold piece. I should just, you know what I should do? I should just stop jumping.
Yeah, I think you'll get real far.
Yes. Oh, well, at least there's a secret forward. Character. That's something.
Oh yeah, what was it?
Teal guy.
Oh, that's right, because you have your...
Yeah.
We go through this every day.
Yeah, that's every time. True. I mean, I just continue the no gold run as if I didn't stupidly jump into this gold piece. And then the next, as soon as I die, which will be every second right now, I will start the Spelunky run without jumping.
I used one bomb to get to a crate, and he had freaking bombs, wee!
Hoorah!
So let's get to that point. And then flee! Oh shit.
Fly, you fools!
Fly, you fools!
Yes! Okay. Well, let's say the cape. I mean, the cape's also supremely helpful when doing, you know, gold runs in the ice caves.
This is...
Well. What happened?
Oh no! The shopkeeper... I mean, it's good.
Are you button smashing?
I sort of was, yeah. The shopkeeper got stuck in the honeybee stuff.
Honeybee
and he was
stuff.
Just right. Yeah, the you know, the
yeah,
wax
know, the
that
beehive.
They have in their hive. And he was right at the place where I had to go down, so he was just stuck there and just shooting constantly.
Nice.
Luckily, he went away. Like, well, I made him go. Well, he jumped.
You basically did you
I helped him out.
Yeah, I see.
But he jumped out of the place that he was at. And then I jumped behind him and killed him. It was quite the fantastic string of events. Okay, this has to happen. This has to happen. I must close that thing. It's not going to happen. This is awful.
Okay.
Did I make it? Nope. There's
I just
no
realized
way I can close this
thing. I just did another no goal run, but I actually really wanted to do like this no jump thing. I can't even keep my own word.
You just can't decide on the wonderful challenge that you're going to embark on.
Okay.
Well, I spent that bomb to get the 4 gems. I just could not help myself.
Okay,
I
need to sacrifice myself. So, no jumping unless I absolutely have to jump.
This is a challenge that will go far.
Okay, so here I have to jump. So you can only run down and whip. That's fun.
Okay,
here I have to jump a couple of times. Okay.
I think this will go to the freaking vault, but if it doesn't, well, I'm screwed. Okay, it does.
Okay.
There's nothing I can do about it. I spent the bombs to get to the vault, and now I can't ghost it.
Oh, really? Is it like in a corner or something?
Yeah, it's in a corner, and the ghost came from the wrong side.
Aww.
Oh well.
No jumping,
I'll just
Patrick.
Have to grab it, I suppose.
Yeah, well. Too shabby. Okay, no jumping.
Nothing.
Uh-oh. Here, I have to. That's really hard. Have you ever tried doing this?
No,
because it's like
it
automatic.
Sounds really silly. But if you say it's hard, it's actually interesting then.
I mean, it's hard because you don't really think of it, you know.
Yeah, you always just jump. There's
I mean, my thumb just does it automatically. I'm I'm 100% sure that people in the comments will be like all over, oh, you fucked it up, you, what can you do? Well, nothing is the answer. Okay. Oh, shit. I didn't quite plan to do this. I do have the teleporter now, though. This is the,
oh, so... with the teleporter, now you are completely disallowed from jumping altogether. You have to use the teleporter instead of jumping at all times.
How do you activate items again? Like X, right?
Uh-huh. Like
but I can't teleport down if I don't jump.
Well, I think that's allowed then, so that you can teleport down.
Okay. So only using the teleporter. Am I allowed to move?
No, you must teleport all the time.
I must teleport all the time. Shit. okay, but I'm not allowed to move, but I'm allowed to jump again. The arrow trap's so going to hit me. No, it didn't.
Pretty sure I missed out on the black market on the first level.
Aww.
Which sucks balls. It's like some serious cojones. Murder, murder everybody.
Wow.
I mean, there's still a chance that the black market's at the very bottom, but I doubt it. I didn't care about keeping Matilda alive, but now I do, because there's a Naltar at the very bottom.
Oh. Well, that didn't go too well with a teleporter.
It didn't know.
Yeah, I was like in a very tiny area where I couldn't really... I mean, since I wasn't allowed to move, I couldn't position myself to have like a better area to teleport to. And the only way I could teleport to was into an arrow trap downwards. So that didn't quite help.
How did that work out?
Yeah, well, and oh, besides, there was also like the shopkeeper right beside. I mean, the arrow trap, I survived. The shopkeeper, I didn't. It's actually very intriguing how you get used to like holding certain buttons and doing things the way you do.
Yeah.
It's very intriguing. I played Ib and Orb yesterday with my girlfriend because we are recording.
It's a cooperative.
Yeah, it's a cooperative platform, and I'm recording the stuff for the next critique, basically.
Uh-huh.
And I realized after playing like 2 hours that my finger started to hurt, and I'm like, why is my right finger starting to hurt? And then I realized I was clenching the right trigger the whole time because I was thinking, I need to hold this to run fast.
That's so much sluggy.
So messed up. And I didn't realize, you know, that's the worst part of it.
Weird. You have been corrupted without mercy by
corrupted without knowing
mechanics.
I think if I would turn off this speed running, you have to hold right trigger, I couldn't play Spelunky anymore.
I tried it out and I failed so miserably. Yeah. I was like, there's
no
way I want to get used
that.
To this.
You should do this as a next challenge.
This is going to be disastrous.
Yes!
It would be the worst, man.
This is why I'm also already loving it. Yes, this is what we do.
I guess we can do that, yeah. I tried it, man. It was like...
And if it's too easy, we
doing.
Totally
like,
do like Frozlunky. This.
It was the like playing Spelunky for the first time all over again. I did not know when to run and when to stay still. It's the weirdest thing. I'm telling you, it's the truth.
Oh, this sounds perfect. Yes, we need to do this.
I will just run into everything and try to... Like, I will try to slow down for you know, getting to a ledge and stuff. And I would speed up instead and just walk everywhere.
Yeah, that sounds amazing. Okay, this is the next plan, obviously.
Shopkeeper is pissed off.
Well, so, again, not much new here.
Yeah, no.
How far are you in?
The wonderful part is that he did not kill me. I am in 2-4. And no chance to black market anymore.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because he was in the first level, but I did not have the bombs to get there. to find out whether the black marker was there or not.
See. Yeah. So you had a rough idea where it was, but you couldn't get there with like
yeah,
bombs?
Yeah, but it could have been at that time. But yeah, I only had two bombs and I would have had to spend them in order to find out whether it was there, so it made no sense.
Oh, I see.
But now I have just one bomb and I'm ghosting two emeralds. It's a pretty sad affair, honestly. If I hadn't wasted a couple bombs trying to kill shopkeepers in the mines, I would be doing much better.
It's always the same, you know? If you don't waste precious resources, you would have been better off. Well, newsflash, Sherlock!
The thing is, I would probably be dead because I would have been rash trying to conserve my resources or whatever. I do that way too often. I'll try to save my stuff and end up killing myself in the most ridiculous manner.
Yeah, yeah. I don't really save my stuff too much, but I tend to get greedy. So that's basically what happened with the ghost in the mines where I died. I really wanted to, you know, get all this stuff ghosted.
Ruby. I'm not going to go for it. Should I?
Ruby's money, man. Sure, everyone needs money.
Oh, $5,000. That's a really expensive fridge.
Well, it's also an ice maker.
Nothing to sneeze off. Okay, I shouldn't play without having climbing gloves by default because I went to use them to go around the ghost.
Nice.
The very last moment I realized, hey, I don't have the climbing gloves, so I'm just going to die now.
Okay, so you're dead.
I am dead. I jumped into the ghost. Imagine that.
I do see a pattern here today. Somewhat.
Oh, man, I didn't realize I didn't have the climbing gloves. That's... So I'm used to having them. Wow, that was really stupid.
Yeah, really odd.
At least I did better than Secret Asian Man.
Wait,
no,
didn't you kill the shopkeeper in the very first shop?
Yeah, I did.
Didn't he have climbing gloves?
No, he had the two pairs of boots, a cape, and something else that I can't remember.
No, I see. I'm already confused between runs.
Yeah, they weren't there.
I did so many runs already, I'm already confused.
Yeah, they're all blended together, man. Too much Spelunky.
Well.
Well,
I'm still running somewhat strong in this no gold
because I've done it a few times, and I die horribly in the mines, and I see you got like a million and a half. It's like, what the hell is this bullshit? So I'm glad that you did not upstage me in this daily challenge.
Yeah, well, you know... Can't win everything. You win some, you lose some, I guess.
Well, lately, man, I'm doing, like, without even recording anything, just for the fun of it, and I'll die in the mine so horribly, and I'll see everybody else do much better, and it's a really sinking feeling of my failure.
Aww.
Then I go to the bathtub and just
you just cry
myself a little.
Until the bathtub is filled. Takes a little bit of time. 5 minutes.
Not that much because I have lots of ice. Especially in my butthole.
So you basically utilize all your feet.
Yes.
Okay,
I'm
so I'm in the ice caves and I still haven't picked up gold, so I'm probably going to pick up gold any second now.
Again, this happens a lot when you're doing the thing.
Yeah! So really, you just need to die quicker. That's like the story.
I just need to die immediately.
Yes.
So that you can have a good no gold
day.
Run.
One day, this support you give me will lead it into me really managing to win a no gold run.
You just might do it. I haven't done speed runs in forever, so I'm going to do it while you die. Because you're going to die.
That's not going to happen.
Die horribly.
How
and
do I
so
go about this?
So terrible at speedruns, that's probably why I never do it. Or maybe I never do it and that's why I'm so terrible at speedruns. Either or, I suppose.
Oh, man.
It's a circle.
The shopkeeper dropped all his money in, like, a really awkward way.
Uh-oh.
Right at the exit. I don't
that's
like this.
Better you say my ass.
Okay, let's whip this away. Yeti, go out of my way.
I have no
idea where to go. I really don't like this. Let's use a rope. You start using resources in a very odd way when things like that are on the brink of defeat, like the no gold run, which is so precious.
Yeah, it's like the whole pacifist runs that I've been doing. You start doing things that you never would think of doing, you know?
Yeah, this is also very intriguing. I love this this idea. But I, you know, suck supremely at it, so...
Yeah, I am so bad at it. Oh, hey, the Jedi, but I'm not going for... Oh, man, and the key was there. That was silly. I'm not going for hell, though. I'm just... Maybe I can get to Olmec in a very short amount of time.
Wow, that was suicidal. I jumped right towards the shopkeeper at the exit and just hoped he wouldn't shoot me. And somehow it worked out.
Somehow it worked out.
You know, sometimes you just need to have a little bit of luck in there. Crazy.
Somehow I'm not yet dead. In fact, I have not been hurt. It's pretty weird. Oh yeah, I did get hurt at some point.
Okay.
It's all these skills I've developed through all my daily challenges, you see.
Yeah.
Put them to good use now with the speedruns. It's just so bad. This seed sucks for speedrunning. All sorts of unavoidable cobwebs and stuff.
Yeah, I feel that in speedrunning in Spelunky, you are so bloody dependent on the seed, which...
I think that's why I don't like it that much, because...
Yeah, I don't really like speedrunning in Spelunky either. It's just too much trial and error.
Yeah, it's kind of depressing, dying so often. Oops, I just quit the game, oops.
Well?
So there's going to be a bunch of black at the end of the video.
Yeah, I mean, finally, we can also already include again, I'm with stupid for you, since last time I fudged up, it's time you fudged up again.
Well, it'll only be a second, so because I'm super fast that way.
Ah, I see.
I'll be back in it, haha! Ow! And I'm dead again. Well, I'm going to be dead now that I'm dead.
God, I almost picked up gold. That was close!
How far along are you?
I'm now entering the temple.
Damn, you might make it!
So now is the fun part. Whew. Okay, how do you do this? I never thought of this, actually. I never thought of really coming this far.
You gotta whip behind every single column, and those little nubs that come out of the ground, they could hide lots of money. Well, actually, 500 gold, that's what they hide.
Hmm.
Not really lots, just 500.
So yeah, there could be like stuff in the sand, right? Basically, that's what you're saying.
The sand?
Yeah, there could be gold in the sand of the temple. Like there's like sand on the ground.
Oh, I'm saying there's these the ornaments that come out of the ground.
Oh yeah, so yeah, yeah, I see what you mean.
Yeah.
Okay. First level done. I think the first one is actually might even be the scariest. I didn't see Anubis. Maybe I was lucky there.
Did you pass it through it already?
Yeah, I'm past the first one now. Oh, and I didn't see any... Now that I think of it, I didn't see any cross traps. So yeah, it was definitely
a
lucky
run,
one.
But it's not really...
It's not really fast.
40 seconds in the second level and the third level. That's still a speed run, totally speed run.
Does the cross
Man,
trap
you're totally
activate?
Gonna do it. Just don't pick up gold at Olmec. That's, I think, the hardest part.
Thank you for motivating me. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Okay. Oh. No! Go away. Enemies that could bump you into...
What kind of health do you have?
Into gold. No fun.
What two. Kind of health do you have?
Yeah, two. Oh, two. Sorry, I was...
You can do it. You're concentrating. Okay. I excuse you.
Totally, yeah. I did hear the question. I was like totally focused on not dying.
Maybe you hadn't heard.
No. It's all right. It's all right. Okay. I do have 27 bombs, so should I ever
get
to Olmec, I should probably just use all of them. Oh man, this is just cruel. Spelunky, this is just cruel.
What happened?
Oh, there's an exit that I... So there's the... But I'm going to take a shortcut here. I mean, they're like the usual path where you wouldn't use any bombs is really cruel. Okay. Don't touch the lava. That would be kind of disturbing. And use the shortcut to the exit again. Okay.
You're now succeeding.
Now don't get killed by the shopkeeper. Okay, it's Olmec time.
Whew. Oh man, this actually might happen.
It's actually what really happened.
I should have died like 20 minutes ago.
Okay, so how do you go about this? I mean, I think you would like get Olmec to the very far left and then go over it.
So many bombs. Yeah, you want to just make a cave. But be really careful, like put the bomb and get the hell out of there every time, because there'll be flying gold all over the place.
Yeah, that's true.
But you know how to make a cave straight down, don't you?
Yeah. So let's prepare some ropes to get over first. And I need one rope to actually really get out of the cave anyways.
Woo!
So...
Son of a bitch.
Okay.
Disgusting shopkeeper.
I would love to have like a crate with ropes in there, but I can't really get to the crate because there's like all emeralds in front of it. Oh, life is so cruel. And since I don't want to use my last rope because I needed to get out of the thing, I'm considering of just dropping down right now. Just blind jump down, losing one hit point. I think that's fine.
As long as you go straight down.
Yeah, okay.
And Olmec is nowhere near to crush your face.
Okay, let's do this. Straight down. Perfect spot for where no gold is nearby.
Do you have just one health left now?
Yeah.
What if the spawns killed you? That would suck ass.
It's not going to happen. I'm going to win this now. This is like totally the plan.
I believe in you.
Thank you.
You can do it.
I'm not quite sure I believe in myself, but yeah. Oh no, there was a sapphire in there.
What the?
But how do you do? I mean, I guess I can go in here, right? So I probably won't be hit by this sapphire. No! I touched it! I'm so bad! Ah, shit.
Oh, man, you were so close. You're bear taffy kind of close. You watch that where he picked up at the last bomb.
That was really bad. That was really, really bad. I should not have done this.
What happened?
You know when you do like a central path down way, there was in the central way, so in the central two blocks, there was one sapphire. And I wanted to place the bomb in the center to make sure that, you know, both blocks are going to be crushed. And since sapphires are, in general, gems are quite large, you can't push it as far left as you would be able to do with gold. So I basically ran into the sapphire.
What was the alternative? Anticlimactic. From afar.
Sheet. Well, it is going to happen one day.
Well, you go further than I ever got, so that's not too bad.
Yeah, well, but you never try. You would be able to do
it. I did this one time get to
see.
Yeah, after like the level before Olmec, and I picked up gold then, it was very sad.
Yeah. I did have, so considering that I did kill the shopkeeper very early to get a bomb box, and I did have very, very nice levels, basically, in terms of platforms I could drop to without gold on it. Because sometimes in the ice caves, if you can only drop down and there's like one piece of gold, and I mean, you're just fucked.
Yeah, yeah.
So that was kind of lucky. And I did take two very important shortcuts. I think three even very important shortcuts through the temple. So I think it might even... I don't know, maybe it's just a thing that is just comes with this specific run I had right now, but I'm considering right now to killing the shopkeepers more often if I have the chance of getting more bombs. Because this helps in creating shortcuts. It's not too stupid.
Yeah, you can
and
just bomb straight down
yeah,
and get to
since
the damn
you don't,
exit.
You don't really plan on killing the shopkeeper anyway, you just want to pop through the exit and go, you know? It doesn't really matter if the shopkeeper's there. Usually, if you have like an open space.
That is a great thing to consider, and I will probably apply it in my subsequent.
In your no gold runs that never ever happen.
I know, I tried to be serious out of it, but I just got too depressed.
That's
awful.
Well, that was fun.
Yeah, it was half daily challenge and another half was just regular crazy gameplay. So that's
that was really fun. I didn't think I would be so happy, even though I failed. That was quite enjoyable.
Yeah, that's cool.
As always, gentlemen,
you live the dream almost all the way to the end.
That's true. Well, you know, you got to try. You got to hit that brick wall all the time to just one day poke your finger through it.
Well, then you'll find out that the wall is made of gold and now you're rich.
Well, if it takes me that long, I'm really questioning my education. Because gold is really soft, you know, you can really hit it very easily.
Well, I don't think you'll break it with your head anyway.
Well, if it's just solid gold, shouldn't be... Yeah, well, okay, your head, I mean... Yes, it's a head. Breaks easily. That's true.
We should make the test about this. This okay, is really important. Burning questions need to be answered.
Viewers, we need you. Who
can
would
a solid
volunteer to run into a solid wall of gold? I would even consider buying one of those to test this. Where do we scrape the money for?
1 foot, 1 foot thick. Can you break it with your head?
We should totally, like, really get some money on YouTube to make this happen.
Yeah, yeah. Do you think a couple thousand dollars that should make it, right?
Yeah, sure. I mean, gold's not expensive, right?
Pretty affordable item. Anyway, we are a bit digressing a little bit, I will say.
Are we really?
I don't know. I think so. That was a weird daily challenge. Maybe we'll have better luck next time.
Yeah, let's see. Thanks for watching. Bye.
See you guys back. See you guys back. See you guys back.